everybody. We're here today to talk about the MEM. The MEM is really a special letter to me because it's associated with the word Mayim. In fact, the Sefer Yetzirah says that that the MEM is from the word Mayim, which doesn't even make any sense because the same text says that the world was created by means of the letters. So the letters were there before the word. Anyway, that's what it says. So Mem is the 13th letter of the alphabet and has a numerical value of 40. It makes a sound like the M in middle. And the Sefer Yetzirah says that it also hums. Hums. So, the Sefer Yetzirah, now the Sefer Yetzirah is the second oldest text in, Kabbalistic text in Judaism. And so anyway, it says basically that divides the letters into three categories. First is the three mothers, that's Aleph, Mem, Shin. And then there's the seven doubles, which can make two different sounds. And then there are the 12 elementals. So Mem is one of the mothers, and that's a big deal. Mem, according to Sefer, the Mems again are Aleph, Mem, Shun. So Aleph means air from the word avir, and Mem means water, from the word mayim, and fire, ash, shin, ash, means fire, and the word is ash. So that's for the shin. So as far as the mem is concerned, God made mem king over the water. And supposedly, and God said that the earth was created by means of the water. So, there you have it. That's what the Sefer Yetzirah has to say. Mem is also one of five letters that have two forms. There's the beginning form. Oh, here, I've got the letters here. That looks like this, water. Oh, why don't you go get your art supplies? I forgot to say that. And then I'll show you some of my mems. Anyway, letters that have two forms are mem and nun. No, kaf, mem, nun, pei, and sadi. So they have the main letter. That's this one again. And then they have the final form, which is that. So you see that the letter is closed all the way around. And supposedly, according to all sources of Kabbalah, the letters of the Hebrew alphabet were carved in stone. You know why they're carved in stone from right to left? It's because that's the way the chisel went. That's why Hebrew is written from right to left instead of like our alphabet, which is written from left to right. So anyway, there's a miracle about this letter, the last letter of the alphabet. The last letter of Mem. This is the final letter. It goes at the end of the word. And the letters were carved all the way through. So the miracle is that the Mem could stay in the alphabet and not fall out. So there you have it. Rabbi Hista said that in the Talmud. I love that story. I do. I love it. Here's another mem that I did. And another. And see, a lot of them have water themes. This is kind of in a wave. And this is in the water. Oh, and here's a final mem again. And this is, I call it the shadow mem because there's a mem behind it. It's barely discernible. Here's another mem. And this is the best mem for water. Standing in the Sea. It's such a wonderful letter. I like it because, I mean, I love all the letters, but I have special ones. And the Mem is special because it is attached to the water. Oh, and I wanted to tell you about, Mem is constructed of a Kaf and a Vav. So here's the Kaf, and here is the kind of Vav. And so the Kaf means 20, and the Vav means 6, which adds up to 26, which is the same gematria as the Yud Hey Vav Ke, name of God. So Yud Hey Vav Hey. So Yud is 10, each of the Heys are 5, and this is 6, so it's 26. So that's a very revered number in Kabbalah, and of course a very revered name. This name is unpronounceable, which is why I call it the Yud Hey Vav Hey, name of God. At one time, the letter was pronounced by the priest, high priest, and he would crawl into this tent and say the letters really, whatever the pronunciation was, really softly. And somehow that was lost after the fall of the Second Temple. Excuse me. So we don't know what the pronunciation of this is. But anyway, the Mem has the same gematria, which makes it very special. So we're going to do a short meditation now, and about the Mem. And the Mem always takes me to water, which, and I love water, especially salt water. I walk on the beach every day, not every day now. I walk 3 times a week and do yoga the other days. But I love to be close to the water. And this is just for me personally. But when I have trouble, if I can just get to the water, I feel like I'll be okay. The salt water. So when I lived in Seattle, that meant the Puget Sound. But here I have a real ocean, the Atlantic Ocean, which is just down the lock for me. So anyway, why don't you take a deep breath? Relax your shoulders. If you put your hands on your lap, your shoulders get to relax. And then you can relax your legs and your feet, because they don't need to do anything right now. You're seated. And your poor feet get a little bit of a rest. And now if you call forth the Mem that you drew and hopefully colored or painted or whatever, or one of my letters, or your own letter that comes to you in meditation, I've never had this one before. This is sitting on the water, and it's what are those things called? Those things that make a lot of noise. They're like motorcycles on the water. Can't think of the name now, but anyway, that's what it is. Only it has a top. I mean, these things don't have tops, but this one does. And it can move very fast, but this one is going really, really slowly and rocking gently. And because it's meditation, this one doesn't make a lot of noise. You know, the slopes, we call these things ski mobiles. There's a different word for them here. So I can see my meditation is going to be really peaceful. Not like it is sometimes when the thing races around all over the place. with the wall, I'm getting, I get soaking wet. And the mem can be pretty funny, but this mem looks like the water. I mean, there's the water under us, but then the mem itself looked like water for some reason. And it's just bobbing along at a really slow rate. It's very peaceful, which I didn't expect. So why don't you stay with your mem for a while? And now it's time to start coming back. So wiggle your toes. And take a few deep breaths. You wiggle your hands too. And then you come back to the room you're in. It's very hard for me to come back because I could sit in there all day. Anyway, if you have any interest in doing this one-on-one, please give me a call. All my information is below. And if you want to see more about the mem, you can go to my website, Hebrew Letters by Sarah Leah. And that link is below also. It's a Facebook page. And I will have mems up all this week, starting tomorrow. Today I'm going to still use the Lamed. So anyway, thanks so very much for being with me. And I hope you enjoyed the mem as much as I do. It's really funny. To me. And I hope I will see you soon the next time. Next week, actually.